Welcome to Bio-Rad's Blackboard Training. This is a series of short, informal tutorials brought to you by industry experts. This video is the second in our WestGuard Rules series. We'll be covering a number of basic concepts that are needed to understand the actual WestGuard Rules. Talking about the rules in the abstract can be difficult to understand. Therefore, illustrating them on a chart can help us take them out of the abstract. To do this, we use a Levy-Jennings chart. To build an LJ chart, we start with the mean of our control data. The next step is to calculate the standard deviation. We now have the framework for our LJ chart. If you're not familiar with the concepts of mean, standard deviation, or Levy-Jennings charts, we recommend that you view our previous videos. Once we have our chart, we can graph our control data points. This makes it very easy to see when a point is not within the expected distribution. Next, it's important to understand that WestGuard developed a system of notation for the rules. The first pattern works like this. N equals the number of QC points, and L equals the standard deviation limit. Here we see a single point that is more than 3 deviations from the mean. It's important to note that the point could appear on either side of the mean. Another type of ruled notation follows this pattern. N equals the number of QC points and bar X is the mean. Here we see the mean. In this case, there are 10 consecutive points on the same side of the mean. An additional rule notation is NT. N is equal to the number of QC data points. T represents the consecutive data points for a single level of control that shows either a strict increasing or decreasing pattern. In this case, there are 7 consecutive points increasing on the same side of the mean. Remember, understanding these notation patterns is a key to understanding the rules. The rules set limits to determine acceptable control values and therefore which patient results are valid. Rules allow labs to set conditions for QC warnings and rejections. Think of a warning rule violation as a heads up that action may be needed. However, in the case of a rule rejection, patient results should not be released. We hope you've enjoyed this brief tutorial. For all of your QC needs, visit www.qcnet.com.